Very good. Now who gave you pleasure? Not Krishna. Krishna is already gone. So this is the example which is given to Rama and Krishna. Some name is given there, I have forgotten. It comes in one of the impressions in this story. So there is no sorrow or no this thing. It is an imagination of the mind again. That is why you can de-imagine. Anything may happen, you can keep yourself without sorrow. It is within your powers, but it requires a lot of efforts. Grace of Lord, grace of Guru, some swadhyaya, all these things together will make you. Yes, you can't keep it. You know the story? In one village, we'll finish it now. Tell the story. In one village, one gentleman lost his son. So there was a very good fakir there, he was living. He went to his house, he told, Bhaiya, who is your son? He came from somewhere, he went somewhere, the Lord gave, the Lord took. So iske liye kya rona dhona kya hai yaar? It is not worth it, you leave it. Then after about 2 months, that gentleman in whose house the son died, he was passing through the fakir's house. The fakir was going on, doing, hi, aisa ho gaya, hi, meri bakri mar gayi, hi, meri ekhi bakri thi mar gayi. So this fellow went and asked him, Swami, aapne hi toh utna kaha ki your son is no son of yours. Kya bakri aapka ho gaya? Bhaiya, wo toh tumhara beta de toh meri bakri hai. This is my lab, that is why I am weeping. That was your son. So I gave you philosophy. So, these are all the place of the mind. So with this we'll stop today. We'll go to sleep tomorrow. So should be.
Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudashyate Purnasya.
You know, I know the answer, but I feel urged to say, why in God's name did Brahman do it? Why in God's name did Brahman do it?
That nobody knows. See, why it was done, as I said, who created, how the arrow was sent, we are not bothered. Try to save the man who has been hit with the poison arrow. That's the only answer we can give. The cold is more today morning. Yesterday evening it was not.
In the morning
now it is.
It is focused, it may increase.
Sushuptikale shatale dilene tamo bhibhuta sukharo bhajeti. When a man sleeps, when everything is gone, then he is full of tamoguna. Tamoguna has got 2-3 effects. One is laziness or lassitude. We call it alas and sleep. These are its main effects of tamoguna. It makes a man postpone things. It makes a man lazy in not doing things. And it makes him sleep. So here, the tamas completely, he is vanquished by this tamoguna. So at night, however much in the daytime he may be full of sattvaguna, he may be full of rajaguna, when the night comes due to the maya, due to the will of the Lord, the tamoguna comes and completely takes over that man.
Is there any way to counteract it?
The way to counteract is in the daytime, if we have been sincere, instead of wasting the time in other worldly activities, we have been taking the smarana of the Lord throughout the day and all that in due course, there cannot be anything. That is why the realized souls, they don't sleep at all. So where is the tamaguna for them? See, throughout night and day, they remain without sleep. There have been yogis who are reputed not to sleep at all throughout the night. At any time, when Bhagavan Ramana was sleeping, anytime anybody just goes near the door from outside, from here say, yeah, who is there? He will ask. So he was so sensitive. So these people are all called, even though they will look as if they are all sleeping lying, they are fully conscious. See, what happened was, Buddha's disciple Ananda, Ananda was his own cousin. He was elder to Buddha. So before he took sannyas, the 2 days earlier he came to Buddha, he said, I am not at your shishya. Today I am your elder cousin. So today I command you that once I take Diksha, Vishu Diksha from me, afterwards I can't, because you become my guru. So now itself I put some conditions. Number one, at all times I will be with you. When you sleep, I'll be with you. When you go anywhere else, I'll be with you. Don't say you don't come here. It's put him in a problem. When Buddha came back, then his wife wanted to see him. He himself took pity. That poor lady, she is not aware of the truth. And she is thinking it is my husband. Her husband is no longer there. I am somebody. I come from the land of Buddhas. I am not her husband. Her husband gone away. He had gone away. So, her life should not be wasted. Let me put some seed of wisdom into her heart. But then, being a lady, if some person is present, she will not open her mouth at all. So she will not be able to weep and tell everything so that he can answer her back. So he requests Ananda. But Ananda says, do you remember what you promised? But anyway, finally he relents. He loves him to go. There's only one question his wife asks. She says, why did you go like a thief at night without telling us? If only you had told, look here, I am going to find out the ultimate truth of the world, there is something behind it. Do you think that I would have stood in the way? Am I such a common girl?
Yes.
So that is one question which Buddha was unable to answer. So, as Ananda put as one of the conditions that I will be always with you, he always used to sleep with him. So one day he asked him, Buddha, several times at night I used to get up and see your face. Your face was absolutely beautiful. It had never for once I found any change in you. Whatever I saw in the morning, I saw in the noon. Whatever I saw in the noon, I saw in the evening. Whatever I saw in the evening, I saw at midnight. That is there. So, how is it you manage to keep yourself, your beauty, 100% okay even during sleep? Normally, even the best beauty queens of the world, if you want to see that beauty, go and meet them at morning 4 o'clock, go and wake them up. Their eyebrows will be without color, and there will be no eyebrows at all.
Eyes will be puffy.
and you will find some of these things coming and falling here, down below.
Falling, yes.
So,
and their hair will be a mess.
So all the beauty will be gone even for them. But you have been maintaining it. What is the reason? He said, beauty is maintained only through consciousness. If you are conscious, the beauty will remain. If you are unconscious, the beauty goes. Yes. See, that is why
yes.
A person while alive, within half an hour when he dies, you go and see his face. That is why we say, why? Your face is just like the face of a dead body. We asked in our, I don't know, in our southern side, this is one of the questions is asked. His face was just like that of a corpse, we say.
Yes, yes.
It will have no life at all. So you will find that consciousness is gone from it. So that is what happens. So he said, and not only that, a lady goes, 3 hours she spends in the beauty shop, she comes back. In the evening she has to be present in a party. The moment she comes, she will tell all her children, hey, don't come anywhere near. You see, don't disturb it.
Right.
So she has to consciously keep the beauty alive. Otherwise,
right,
beauty
right,
will
right,
be displaced.
Right, yeah, yes.
So he says, throughout night I am conscious, and that is the secret of all beauty. Be always conscious. That's all. So Sushaptikale Esakale Biline Tamo Bibhuta Sukharupameti Abhibhuta means he is completely overwhelmed by the tamoguna, overwhelmed by the darkness in his mind. Then what happens is, sukha rupa meti, here the beauty is, even though the ignorance is covering him, the ignorance is there at one corner, he becomes the form of bliss. In sleep, you alone are there, absolutely you are not aware of any other adjuncts, that I am a man, I am 70 years old, I am an engineer, I am this, nothing is there, you are the pure consciousness without a body, and that pure consciousness, that is bliss. When you simply live, that in your amness, I am, don't add anything to it, don't add, the moment you add, I am a man, then you are afraid of animals. The moment you say, I am 76 years old, you are jealous of the 25-year-old people or 30-year-old people. So anything you add, there is something else above it. So you feel that you are inferior. So that becomes the cause of all miseries. So do not add anything, remain in that amness just like the newborn child. So that is the best way, and then you get all this. So that is the time when the mind ceases to work. So this is the way to prove it is the mind which has created the entire world. It is an illusion. Because the maximum happiness you got not in your waking state with all your millions and with all your 25 beautiful wives and 85 children. You didn't get it even during your dream, because a similar sukha and dukkha followed you, a similar misery and joy followed you in your dream also. But this is the only time when the mind left, the mind was not there at all. Both the indriyas have ceased and the mind also has ceased. And what happens in the dream? The mind existed, the indriyas had ceased, the senses had ceased. But here is a case where everything, a complete cessation of indriyas of your mind, maximum happiness is only during that daytime. That is one of the proofs that take away the mind, you are happy. That is the lesson we get out of it.
Right.
Tamo bhimuta sukharupamiti. Then the question is, why should one be sleeping completely? If we are with God, our purpose is to be with God, then let me be sleeping, I'll be with God only. But you cannot. Now in the next one or so, he is again going to say, the next one is going to say, you can't, you will have to wake up. So when you wake up again, that ignorance which was lying in a corner, just waiting for you, biding its time, it just is on you, and then again in the morning you are back. So there is no use of having a joy for 2 minutes with fellows holding their guns at your throat. It's not a joy at all. You are having a joy. See, a man who is going to be hanged early morning at 5 a.m. Supposing at 4 a.m. they take a lot of sweet things which he relishes a lot, all delicious food. Will he be able to take it when he knows within another hour he is going to be hanged? So this is like that only. As the ignorance is still lying there in that in corner, so that is not a complete one, because you know pretty well this is only temporary. You want a Brahman with whom you can live forever. So then what happens? He is sleeping. Why is he not always sleeping? What makes him get up at all? What makes him get up at all? It is the vasanas and the prarabdha of the past birth which doesn't allow him to sleep longer. It comes back. Janmantara karma yoga. Punascha janmantara karma yoga. Sayeva jiva svapiti prabuddham. So the same jiva which was sleeping, it again wakes up. Why should it wake up? Janmantara karma yoga. In some previous births it has done some various karmas. Those karmas had to have an effect. So the karmas have got a twofold effect. One is prarabdha, the other is vasanas. When once I do one action, she leaves her purse, I take it away and keep it with me. So I have done something wrong, so I should have a punishment in the next birth. So this is being kept in my account, that this fellow is to be punished for this deed. So this is called the prarabdha. Rather, he is the reward or the punishment, the reaction which you are getting in the next birth for an action than the previous birth. Apart from that, every action leaves an impression in your heart. That is called the vasana. Normally what happens is, we make a little difference between vasana and samskara. In the common parlance, it is not in the philosophical side, but in the common parlance we make. Any good deed you have done when they leave the impression, I have been going every day to the temple and praying to the Lord, so it is a good impression, we call it samskara. And anything bad I have been doing, I have been going out and playing at for stakes in the casino, and that is a bad impressions which have come in, so we call it as vasanas. But vasanas themselves, we call them as good vasana and bad vasanas. But in the common parlance, the common method of terminology, people call the bad actions, which are the impressions of bad actions as vasanas, the impressions of good actions as samskaras. This is only in practice that is there. So, apart from that, what does this impression do? This impression goes on itching, makes you itch for repeating that same act. If I had once gone to the temple, then that is there inside. That is my advisor for future free actions in the next birth.
So it's called an inclination. You're inclined to do it.
But these are the latent propensities which are lying from the past actions. You call it the latent propensity or the inclination. They are not inclination which come from now, from a desire. These are something which you can't help. These are some compulsory propensities which are latent.
So vasanas don't really comprise one's personality. Personality is different.
Personality is composed of all these things together. See, after all, a personality is assumed. A Brahman has no personality. So all the personality of a jiva are all due to all these things only. Or they are all due to the traits which you have acquired from the past, the input which you are still having in this birth, by environment, by education, by genes. So all these things put together make up the personality. So the vasanas and samskaras are part of the personality. They don't form the whole of the personality. They form part of it. That's right. So these are the adversaries which in the next birth, see, you have got 100% free will apart from prarabdha. What is prarabdha? Prarabdha doesn't make you do an action. Prarabdha is only a result of an action which comes, which you can't help. I go there, I get into an accident. This is not an action I have done. This is only a reaction of something which has come on me now. I suddenly fall ill, I got typhoid, and then something happens to me at that time, I go into coma. So you are just explaining. When a person sleeps, he gets up in the morning. He doesn't sleep for 20 days, 30 days, 40 days like Kumbhakarna. So why does he do it? Why can't he sleep throughout the night? Because in the sleep you are having maximum bliss, absolute happiness. So during sleep you never have any sorrows, no miseries, no dukkha. So why don't you continue to sleep? The reason is, there are the effect of the previous karmas done in the past births will not allow him. So that karmas are of two kinds. Say, in this birth, you have left your purse and gone away. I was in need of money, I found there are 2,000 rupees. Oh, Mr. Mahesh is a rich man, he won't miss it. So it will come useful for me, I keep it. And nobody is going to suspect such a big Swamiji who is talking on Vedanta. So I keep it with me. So now this is a bad action I have done, which is against the Shastras. One should not do Asteya. This is one of the Niyamas. One should not do any chori. So I have done it. So I should have the punishment for it. I do a good deed, I should have the reward. So this is called the Prarabdha. Prarabdha is a reaction to an action. Jo karma kiya, uski pratikriya jo hai, usko prarabdha kehte. So that pratikriya is not given in this birth, because that will confuse the computer. which is going on allotting, because it has to give you a punishment. That punishment has to be meted out by somebody to whom you did something bad in this birth. He should be born at that time, he should be somewhere near you. This sort of combination becomes very difficult. So he does it only for the next birth, he keeps everything ready, the book is kept ready. So he will be there on that very day, when you are there. So he should also be born by that time. So these timings are all done very nice. So prarabdha is only an incident or an accident which happens. This is only a reaction which happens. This is not a karma or an action which you are doing. If in this birth you come for the satsang, this is not prarabdha. This you are doing out of your free will. But even though technically there is a free will, you could have come here. Or somebody said there is a pop music concert going on somewhere there, you might have gone there also. So you think it is your free will you came, it is not your free will. Even though you have the power to choose, but you have lost that power due to your own disability. There is a governor in the president's rule. President's rule comes, say, in Gujarat. So there he is given two advices, two senior IAS secretaries, they are made his advisors. Now these advisors, they tell him, don't do like this. So one man tells him, you do like this, it will be very good for the people. But that man's voice is feeble, he is unable to express himself properly. The other secretary is a very senior man. If you do like this and ever more, in future you will never become a governor. They will dismiss you now itself. Then this fellow is afraid. So he does, yes, what you say is true perhaps. So I will do accordingly, he said. He has got the free will, but still he goes according to the stronger advisor. Similarly in our mind, when I have taken the purse, it has left an impression here. Heart and the chitta, it has left an impression. So that impression will make you do it again and again. Yahi salahkarai, he is the advisor for the future. He is only an advisor. Nowhere in any conflict is written, you have to do according to his advice. You can do as you like. You are the governor, he is not the governor. You can do. But a governor is afraid. He thinks that man has got ability, he is talking so strongly, he has got experience. So you follow what he says. It has become a habit. So wherever you are a governor, you will be governed by somebody else. You would not like to exercise your free will. In a similar way, in the previous birth, you went 40 times to satsang and temples. So that left a vasana. And the more the number of times you do the same action, the vasanas become stronger, 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 stronger. And in the next birth, this vasana, which has been done a maximum times where the impression is very strong, it will talk in a very aggressive way, loudly, so that you will be afraid not to follow the advice. That is there. So if in this birth, I have done 1,000 times, I have gone and Jua Khela, I was playing some dice and losing money. And some 10 times I have gone to a temple. So in the next birth, when one evening comes, you want to know what you can do, then this small, the 10 times only you have gone, to say, today there is a nice satsang, somebody is going to tell Bhagavad, wouldn't you go there? But its voice is feeble, because we have done it only 10 times. The other one where you had gone for Jua Khelna, to play dice, you have done it 1,000 times, it is very strong. Huh? You have been going to various Bhagavad. Kya hua? What has happened? Is your anger now less? Are you getting more money? Nothing. So what is the use of going there? You go for dice. You may get place 1 rupee and you may get 20,000 rupees. You go and give it to that Swami who is doing this Bhagavad. You may get at least some punya. It will put it so beautifully, so nicely, that vasana. You would like it. So in one's life, 20% only is prarabdha. 80% is your free will. Now whatever you do now, good or bad, this becomes the prarabdha for the future births. That is what has happened. So what you can do, you have got a free will, you are swatantra, but still you go by according to the vasanas, and that is why we get caught. And the vasanas are so prabal. In Viveka Chudamani, he has defined the vasana as purvapara vicharana vina karma. What happens is, the pratikriya, from previous birth I have been suddenly acting with anger, so anger has become one of my vasanas. So many times I used to slap people, fight with people, so with the result that has become my vasana. So in this birth, I am sitting in a bus with barefoot. Somebody comes and just places his booted foot on me, I am getting a pain. Immediately I don't even see who the fellow is, tomorrow I slap him. And then I find he is the superintendent of police of that place. You can now know what will happen. If only he had waited for a few minutes. So this is something which is done automatically, because the vasana is so strong, you don't even hesitate to think about it. What will happen? Purva means what has happened earlier. Apara means what will be the consequence later. You don't bother to know the pros and cons. Purvapara means the pros and cons. What are the advantages? What are the disadvantages of doing it? Is there any advantage by my slapping? Will he now correct himself and will he say, oh, I am very, very sorry? He may not say unless he happens to be a bhakta. Otherwise, you will be put inside the jail. That's all. That is what is going to happen.
We had a minister of education in the state, and there was an assembly questioner. So we used to brief him on the earlier day, and the minister desired that I want to answer like this. The person who was briefing, he told that, no sir, you can't answer like that. You have to answer as I say and not as you wish. Then he got found, who is minister? I am minister. He says, sir, you are not only a minister, you are honorable minister, but you have to say as I say and not as you wish. Very boldly he told him, he was deputy secretary, Mr. Sayyar. Then he said, why are you insisting like that? No, he told that if you continue to answer as you wish, then I will have to inform the senior minister, and the consequences you will have to face. Then he said, what is the reason behind that? And he advised that, sir, you are committing on the floor of the house, and whatever you speak on the floor of the house becomes a commitment as a part of commitment. And so then we have a very bad financial professor, and that is why I have to say, you simply answer like as I tell and you sit down, that's all. Then he said, oh, it's my special of my prestige. Whatever it may be, sir, but you have to pay like this only. This is called something.
This is the vasana. This is the vasana. But that happened to be a fairly good vasana. That could be a bad vasana. For his own process, he may advise him. Give him a wrong advice and make him do it also.
This brings up a very important point, that if you have good vasanas, you've gone to temple and satsang 1,000 times in past life, so that voice is telling you go. But also you have the vasana which causes you to lose the discrimination of concerning consequences of actions.
Yes.
Even though you're going to temple, you've got that along. So, is it true that some sadhana must be applied to remove that bad vasana?
Exactly so. See, the vasanas are there. All the vasanas should be removed. So we have got a separate skandha in our Bhagavata called Vasana Nirasana Skandha. How to eliminate the vasanas? There are so many methods. Number one, suppose you got a vasana of being a miser, you don't want to spend any money, you go on this thing. Then the way to do it is, you start doing dana. And you go to the satsanga, then you will get those habits usually. When you find everybody giving something to that Swamiji, then you will say, oh, how people will think, so I have to give. So you will begin. And after doing it twice or thrice, you would like to do it. Yes, poor fellow, he doesn't have anything at all. So then you will go and even tell him, Swamiji, shall I give you a dhoti? So he will go further up. So his vasanas will come down.
But what about the more dangerous vasanas seem like, okay, you have the character trait of being miserly or being cruel, that's one thing. But the one that affects your own inner state by saying, I'll do something and I won't feel the consequence. What inner sadhana? What practice must be applied to remove those deep-rooted things?
There is one brahmastra. That brahmastra means there is an atomic bomb which will solve the entire problem of the world in one stroke. And that is called the prayer to the Lord, a continuous prayer to the Lord, worship of the Lord, taking the names of the Lord. The more you go on doing it, all the vasanas will go. But in addition to it also, because initially itself you will not be able to do it with that full zeal and full pressure. That is why side by side, do these things also,
right,
as giving dan or going to satsang and then reading some Ramayana or Bhagavata, having a reading class there, calling some people and then read. So this sort of thing side by side with it will help you a lot, because it will accelerate the process. Because the God Himself means it has to come to a particular level before it can help you. I start today twice, I said Rama, Rama, and then say, oh, nothing has happened, Rama has not done anything, that won't do. So it requires a particular level up to which you have to reach in your sadhana when that begins to work.
So this is the case where you don't try to detach from your vasanas, you just attach to the Lord, the detachment automatically.
That's perfectly okay. See, what happens is, there is a very big rock and I have to push it down. So I push it once, twice, thrice, 20 times. 19 times it didn't move. 20th time it only fell down. Does it mean only the 20th time only it acted? No. Each one was taking away a little of the friction. And the 20th was the culmination where all the friction was gone, it was able to go down. So you have to reach that state to make the Lord move. You will have to push Him 20 times. So till that time you will be accumulating further vasanas. So to avoid it, you do the rest of things which are a bit easier. See, people will find God as the hardest practice. So if you tell them, this is nothing out of a purse, you give 20 rupees to the poor man, it is the easiest sadhana, many will do it. Because you give it and forget about it, 20 rupees is nothing for me. If you tell him half an hour you sit and do brahmana, it will be more difficult.
It's a big investment to remember.
So, as if these are some easier things to start, this will again lead him to the God. Going on doing it, the manashuddhi, it happens. That which prevents him from thinking of God, then automatically he will begin to think of God in due course also, in a more sincere way. So if both go together, it is the best initiative.
So manashuddhi is a purification of the mind.
Purification of the mind. Purification of the mind, things which act against your thinking of the Lord, they are all these things like greed, anger, passion, lust, desires, all these things are there. So when all these things have to go, you have to start in a way. In this way, then that's the one.
But you say the thing which purifies the mind most is remembrance of God.
Remembrance of God, that's there. See, not only that, what happens is, if you do it, in the next birth it automatically comes. A big elephant was caught by a crocodile. Then it begins to praise the Lord. In 32-35 slokas, each one is a quintessence of the entire philosophy, Vedanta's essence. How can an elephant think of talking of God in this way? So he says, Evam vivasito buddhya samadhaya manokriti jajapa paramam japyam prajanmanyanushitam. It suddenly came into its mind that in the previous birth I was telling the shloka, I was a king, all the shlokas came, it did it. So this was the vasana. Previous birth he was a king called Indradyumna. He was every day doing prayers for hours together, and there was a particular prayer which he used to do daily for 2 hours. So in 70 years of his life he has done it, that came to his rescue in the next birth, that came immediately. So these vasanas come to you suddenly for help if they are good. Similarly, the reverse also can happen. A bad vasana may come and it can create calamity in your next birth. So both things happen. That is why it is required. And they have said, Apadi smarana, vipadi dana, means sampadi dana. These are the two things. That is why in Ashtamaskanda there are two stories which are given. When you are in calamity, think of him, think of him, think of him, that alone can save you. Even if you have never done it, do it with all the despair of the last minute. You do it, that intensity will be sufficient and he will come to your rescue. So that is what the Gajaraja did. And Mali was full of wealth. All the wealth of three worlds was his, that asura. He got God himself to be his gatekeeper. Later on when he took him, he offered himself to the Lord, because he asked for three steps by him. He thought he's a small fellow, he requires only this much land. The moment he said, I have given, he immediately grew up into a cosmic figure. And he had three steps. By his entire body he occupied all this interim space and the heavens too. And by one foot he has covered the entire earth. He said, hey, you said three steps, where will I keep my third step? He said, still my head is there. Mali says. So when you are having enough of money, give Daan. Doesn't matter if you have to lose all, you lose all to gain all.
Right.
So that is the idea behind it. So that is what we did. So later there are various methods how to do this manner of these other things. And Hiranyakashipu, the father of Prahlada, was an asura. He was full of anger against his son. He did everything to kill him. So he was the bad vasana which was trying to affect him. And Prahlada was the epitome of good vasanas, always thinking. So when he took Narayana, Narayana, nothing could affect him. He was thrown from the top of the hill down. He was safe. He was trampled by the feet of hundreds of elephants going over his heart. He was safe. They tried to stab him. Nothing could pierce him. That's what happened. So that is how all these things are there.
Right.
So that is the final one. But in between, these things are also side by side required to explain the efforts. That
Apadi Smaran Sampadi Dhanam.
Sampadi Dhanam. That is the two stories. So what happens is, because of these vasanas, he has to do some acts now. The vasanas are telling him, you do this, do this, do this, do this. So he has been going to office thousands of times, not only in this birth, in so many births. So he can't afford to sleep. That tendency for going to office at morning 8 o'clock, it will make him get up. There is one of the vasanas which has come. So like that, there are so many vasanas. He has to go to the market early in the morning. He had been doing it for several births. So he has to get up in the morning and do. Or he has been a very good bhakta in previous births, getting up at 4 o'clock and doing immediately the prayers. For janmas and janmas he has been doing. So in this janma he will not be allowed to sleep beyond 4 o'clock. He gets up again. So like that, it is the karmantaras which are to bear fruit. Now the vasanas as well as the prarabdhas will make him get up. So punascha janma antara karma yoga. Because of the effect of the karmas which have been done in the previous births, which are in the form of vasanas or proclivities or propensities or inclinations, latent inclinations, which you call as vasanas or samskaras. Sayeva jiva svapiti prabuddha. So the jiva, the one who slept first, he becomes awakened. He wakes up again. He comes back to the state. Not that when he sleeps, he goes to sleep permanently. That permanently doesn't happen. Otherwise, I will say, whether the maya is there or not, I am with Brahman, let me continue forever in this itself. What does it matter to me? Puratraya kridatiyascha jivaha. Thus, the jivatma, the soul which is inside you, it is playing in all the three states. It in the waking state, it goes to the office, it marries, it caters to the needs of his son, wife and all these things, that is the play. So in the dream again, it happens in a different way, different story, different wife, different son, different office. So there again a similar play is enacted. And then in the sleep, he doesn't play anything, he remains absolutely quiet and gives you ananda, but at the same time, early morning you are aware that I slept. Even though during sleep you are not having that consciousness. So it is the jivatma, it is that soul which has been playing in all the three things. Now, this Parodriya can be interpreted in three ways. Either avasthatraya, the three avasthas like waking, sleeping or things, or the waking sleep represents the sthula sharira or the gross body, and the dream, there you are seeing the sushma sharira or the subtle body or the ethereal body. Then during your sleep, only the pure ignorance is there, which is called the karana sharira. It is not a body, but that ignorance, that avidya is there, you are staying there. So these are the three taus. There is sthula sharira, then the sushma sharira, and thirdly the karana sharira. So it is playing in all these things. So whether you call the three states or whether you call the three shariras, it means one and the same. Puratraya kriyadati yascha jivaha. Then, while you are asleep, there was no world. You only presumed the world was there. You never knew. You never saw the world there. Is it not? But you say, I didn't see. My friend Swami Sadashivananda is waking up throughout the night and he was seeing from time to time this room existed, this Narmada Darshan existed, and the Kachiyasana existed. But who is he? He is also part of your dream. You are dreaming him. Your dream object told you that it is true. So you won't believe it. Let somebody come outside your dream and tell you, then I will believe it. He is part of your dream. Inside your dream you see so many things. Waking state was a dream. So you slept during your dream, and this man didn't sleep, he was awake, but he is part of your dream. So I would take his statement as correct, unless somebody comes outside your dream. That is clear. Nobody can come, because whoever you see, he is in your dream only. So what happens is, when you slept, there is nothing at all, no world. The moment you got up, what is the first thing which came? The world didn't come to you. The moment you got up, I remember, oh, I am Shantananda. Then after about 2 minutes, I am going to the bathroom. I only remember the bathroom. The first one which came after the world is, the bathroom came. Oh, I have to go to the bathroom. So the first item of the world. The moment I went to the bathroom, while going itself, suddenly I remembered, I should remember, yaar. Today at 10:30, my Chachaji is coming. I have to go to the railway station. He has written 100 times. Kal phone bhi kiya tha. He told me, or told me over the phone, I have to go there. Oh, I should be back by 1 o'clock. Today we have to do this seminar. I have to go and make arrangements for the conference. So the entire world comes. So you create the entire world, your office, your house, your wife, your son. Today evening you have promised to take your son to the zoo. The zoo came, your son came, the entire world has come within about 5 minutes time or 10 minutes time. So, the world is coming from the aham. It is aham which created the Vishwam. When you were asleep, neither the aham was there nor the world was there. The first one was I, the consciousness of the self, the I came. The moment the I came, this I or the jiva, it created all these things. This I or the ego, it is the same as the jiva. According to our Vedanta, jiva is not something else. That which says I, Shantananda, that I, that is the jiva. That is the Atman, which has identified itself with this body and thinks I am this body, and that is called the jiva. So the moment it says this body is mine, I am this body, then that I has come. So that is called the ego. So the ego is the same as the jiva. Tatastu jatam sakalam vichitram. So when the jiva has woken up, this entire world has come out of it. Tatastu jatam, from that has come out, has arisen sakalam vichitram. All these things, vichitra means various vivid varieties. See, the world is not only one, there are so many varieties. So the entire varieties of the entire world with all its varieties has come out of that eye. Then, Adharam Anandam Akhanda Bodham. yasmin layam yati purutrayam cha. Now when something comes up, when something is there, what is the adhara, what is the foundation behind it? If this building is there, this building cannot stand unless there is an adhara. If you bring some milk from outside, the milk cannot be brought unless there is an adhara. There is something which, some support, some substratum on which it can stand. Now, even for any false appearance, there has to be an adhara. Because if something comes and goes, it has to be an adhara. Supposing you see a cinema, in a cinema, man comes, he lives a life, he goes, you are seeing the entire story. Now, that which is moving, it cannot move unless an unmoving curtain is there behind it. So the curtain is called the adhara, and this rest of the things which are having the support, they are called the adheya. That is how it is like. So, adharam anandam akhanda buddham. This jiva which is coming inside, where from it has come, who is the adhara for that? What is the one from which it has arisen? The adhara is that supreme bliss. Who is that supreme bliss? He is that consciousness. Which consciousness? A consciousness which is unbroken, which is akhanda,